Ready, start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, I think the importance of my resolution has been accepted on all hands, and from the way in which interest has been shown from the discussion on it, I am convinced it is the subject of prime importance in the country today. While there has been by and large support to the recommendation that I have made, namely monopoly procurement of essential commodities, there have been a few voices of some adverse comments. Therefore, I would like to deal with those a little before I go on to the subject matter of the resolution and the need for compiling with it. Mr. Tyagi maintained during the discussion that he was apprehensive that if monopoly procurement is resorted to, it will take away the element of competition, and it is the element of competition which is inherent in free trade. Laissez-faire policy, to which he attaches so much importance, that this resolution, in his opinion, should not be accepted. I am afraid what Shri Tyagi ji has said and those who subscribe to his way of thinking, his ethos, his philosophy on such questions will lead to sure disaster, because the only example which Tyagi ji gave us, say of a rickshawala, during the old days he used to stand near Connaught Circus and for ananas the rickshawala could take him to any distance he liked. I am afraid we are living in a world far different from what it was, say, 30 years ago or 40 years ago. Therefore, I am afraid Tyagi ji's approach is rather obscurantist, and it is a little difficult to swallow it, and I can suggest that he should ponder over it to realize that but for the fact that government had some reserves, it would not have been possible to meet the overwhelming situation which the country had to face during the drought. If Tyagi ji thinks that because of the free trade prices would come down to a normal level, I would only quote to him the example of those commodities which are not under control. It is only wheat which was intended to be brought under control, which was intended to be procured in a monopolistic manner, and it was intended to be disturbed through a government machinery. The other commodities, their prices were hiked, the commodities were hoarded, public institutions were exploited with their money for holding a veritable disaster on the verge of which the country had to live so long was created. Therefore, the machinery under private agencies for the distribution and procurement can under no circumstance either be encouraged or allowed. The other comment made was by my friend of the DMK. He seems to think that monopolistic procurement and distribution would lead to disruption, and he also said that there was no confidence in the agencies dealing with procurement and disruption of food grains. I personally think that this is a question which is not restricted to party policies. Here are the basic requirements.